I'm George Koo. I've been a GP since 1989. Even throughout the course and up to now, it has certainly helped me to understand mental health diseases a lot better. And it's given me a lot more confidence in seeing patients.
Before the GPMH, I always had this, I always shy away from mental health illnesses. Not because of the person, but because of myself. I felt inadequate to handle, say, cases like schizophrenia or bipolar and all the psychosis. And then, but having gone through the course, I felt that I have plugged up all my gaps in my knowledge, and then I felt empowered, and I feel that I can help my patients better.
I'm Dr. Rodney Lim. I've been a GP since the year 2000, private practice. Since attaining the GDMH, of course, I have more confidence in managing psychiatric patients, and I think psychiatry forms a large part of our general practice. So with the GDMH training, personally, I find that I'm more confident and able to delve deeper and help patients with their problems. The other thing with GDMH is that they open a lot of doors for me, in particular the support services, the paramedical services, and all these give us the benefit to manage patients better.
My name is Choi Young. I've been a doctor since 1992. So I've been delivering babies for quite a long time. My specialty is obstetrics and gynecology. So I look after women. I took GDMH firstly just about 2 years after I took a graduate diploma in acupuncture. And these are the two aspects of medicine that I was very interested in. I've always wanted to know how we can incorporate Eastern and Western medicine together. And I think for a lot of primary care physicians, they would really benefit because mental health is a very, very big aspect of ensuring that the whole population is happy and healthy. You cannot be healthy if you're not happy, and you cannot be happy if you're not healthy. So it goes hand in hand. Understanding and helping people achieve better mental health is definitely